Howard, you said when this happened, you were personally ashamed, embarrassed, and you said we were wrong in every way. Can you say definitively these two men were arrested and the police were called because they were black?
I can absolutely say that of all the incidents and situations in the almost 50 years of history at Starbucks, this situation was not only reprehensible, but we were ashamed, horrified, and I think it's totally inconsistent with the values and guiding principles and the humanity of the company. And that's why we've taken such a swift action, immediately going to Philadelphia, meeting with the two young men, apologizing, and then asking ourselves, in view of what took place, we have a responsibility, a moral obligation, to look at this and realize we need to advance the training about the issues that the country is facing and what is happening in our stores.
So that will happen today. 8,000 Starbucks stores across the country are going to be closed all afternoon.
Yeah.
You're going to train 175,000 workers on anti-bias training. Some of that is going to be showing them this documentary by the legendary documentary filmmaker Stanley Nelson, which I watched part of it, where you have young black men and women talking about wanting to walk out of a house and feel as safe as any white person would feel. You're going to have the woman Sherrilyn Ifill, who heads the NAACP Legal Defense Fund, participating in this training. What will actually happen?
Well, first off, I've gone through the training myself, okay, as has the entire leadership team of the company last week. And we did that so that we could experience it firsthand. It's interactive. It's been co-authored by Brian Stevenson, Sherrilyn Ifill, Heather McGee. And I think we wanted to try and really get professional people to help us understand and walk in the shoes of people of color and understand that racial bias does exist. Unconscious bias exists, and what can we do as a company to create the reference points to establish empathy and compassion and a welcoming environment for everyone?
For critics who say this is an afternoon, how on earth can you tackle racial bias and unconscious bias in an afternoon?
Well, I think the most important thing to do is we need to have the conversation. We need to start. We realize that 4 hours of training is not going to solve racial inequity in America or anyone coming into our stores that may have a problem, but we have to start the conversation. We've also said that we are deeply committed to this being a long-term journey in which we are going to integrate this training not only in every Starbucks store from this point on, but also the onboarding of 100,000 new people a year.
So this is the beginning of more trainings to come?
Yes, without question, and we're going to do this around the world.
What was the gut, Howard? I've interviewed you for, I don't know, almost a decade now, right? And this company is as ingrained in you, arguably, as almost as family. You are Starbucks. Starbucks is you in many ways. So can you just tell me your gut? What did you feel when you realized this happened to these two men because of their race?
I was personally horrified by it. When you think about the values of Starbucks, providing health insurance, free college tuition, the things we've done for opportunity youth, veterans, refugees, all of these things, for this to happen is such an anathema. However, it did happen. And we did not blame the manager. We took full responsibility. I took full responsibility, immediately went to Philadelphia. But from a personal level, it was hard for me to actually imagine this could happen at Starbucks. And in a way, because it did happen.
Why is it hard for you to imagine it could happen at Starbucks? You think of sort of on every corner, and you think about race relations in this country. I mean, there was a poll last year that showed that 70% of Americans feel like race relations have gotten worse in the last decade.
Because the culture and values of the company are so steeped in compassion and humanity. 40% of our workforce are people of color. We've hired over 100,000 opportunity youth over the last couple of years. So we are steeped in an understanding of inclusion and diversity as part of the history of Starbucks.